If you look at the map, you'll see that there aren't any borders between oceans, and that gives you an idea that they sort of merge smoothly one into another. The truth, however, is that oceans are practically divided on the very bottom. You see, different oceans have different density, different salinity, and temperature, and that leads to most peculiar collision. There are a couple of places where you can visually see how two oceans meet, but they never mix. This is a rather new phenomenon. It was discovered very recently. You can find a lot of videos online where Atlantic and Pacific oceans clash against one another. And on these videos, you can clearly see that they don't mix. The border between the two is like a separation between two worlds. It's out there, everyone can see it, but it's very mysterious. It's like there's an invisible wall between two oceans. The border doesn't let one go into another. So what's the deal? Why is it that those two don't mix? It would seem very natural if they would. Turns out, water can be very different. It is believed that Atlantic and Pacific oceans have very different chemical compound, but you don't need to be a chemist to see the difference, because you can see with your own bare eyes that even the color is not the same. Thing is, denser liquid will ultimately be at the bottom, and that which has less density should be on top. In that case, the border would be vertical, not horizontal, and the difference in salinity would level as oceans approach each other. However, there are several reasons why this doesn't happen. Not only is that the difference in density is quite insignificant to lead to rapid lowering of one of the oceans and rise of the other, but it's actually enough to prevent mixing. Inertia also plays a big deal in all of this. It's the Coriolis force, to be more precise. It shows up when at an angle movement towards the rotation axis. The fact is that two oceans have different current directions. In addition to that, the waters of these oceans have one very important difference. It's the difference at a key parameter, the one that has to do with the strength of the molecules, or the surface tension, let's say. In short, it's the force due to which the molecules of the substance kind of hold on to each other. In these two oceans, such a force is fundamentally different, which ultimately prevents mixing. Maybe after some time they would gradually mix, that is if their currents coincide, of course, but since they move in different directions, they simply do not have time for that. You may be thinking that all of this is just water, but in reality it's a very complex phenomenon that is hard to explain or even to put into words. It's relevant not only with Pacific and Atlantic oceans. In the same way, Atlantic does not mix with the Caribbean Sea, Baltic and North Seas. Even some rivers clash, while others flow into one another without problems, like Brazilian river Rio Negro, for example, simply refuses to mix with other rivers. Same goes for Russian Chuya and Katyn rivers, American Green in Colorado, and many others. In Germany, however, there's one particularly interesting instance, wherein Dunabi and Ilz, falling into each other, flow further, each according to their chosen path. They initially mix, but only after a while. Oceans, however, is a completely different game. In general, we don't know how to explain this stuff. It just rearranges itself. That's how it feels to me. That's all for now, guys. Don't forget to press the like button if you like this video. And of course, subscribe to AmaziCo to stay tuned for more. See you next time.